So I discovered quite by accident a few months ago that Hinton, Oklahoma has this drag strip here, a nice quarter mile of rubberized concrete. So let's see what 152 horsepower can do. Okay, so my car is obviously not a drag racing machine, but it's kind of fun to mess around out here. But it helps to make a point that, you know, if my car were a drag racing machine, it'd be pretty useless for anything else. It might be really successful in that one thing for a short amount of time. It would break, be forgotten, and be replaced. But as it is, it's something that is not just good at that one thing, and so is useful in lots of situations, will last a long time, and does what really needs to be done for normal life. The church is like that. Now, this analogy falls short in lots of ways, but sometimes we expect the church to be the thing for the moment and to have, you know, everything together in a precise way and keep up with the cultural, you know, the expectations for the moment. But that's not really what the church is for. The church is the stable place of Christ in the world that survives throughout the centuries and endures all things and survives all things and surpasses all things. But she's not concerned with being popular in the moment. She's not concerned with what politicians think. She's not concerned with what the cultural estimation of morality is. She's concerned with providing for her sheep, her flock, throughout history until Christ comes again. So, just like my car, my little Subaru Crosstrek here is not a drag racing car, but is actually better for that. It's a much more useful car that actually connects with my human needs. So also the church is not the cool thing, not the popular thing, not the thing that is going to draw the most attention or even at times seem the most reputable. But here she is, enduring through the centuries, whatever is cool, important, and, you know, must have, must do right now. The church will survive longer than that, be the source of grace longer than that, be Christ's presence on earth longer than that. And so we don't need to worry that she's not those other things. It's okay that she is not what the world expects her to be or wants her to be. She is who Christ needs her to be, and that's who we need her to be.